Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing mathematical tool for physics, and this is a lecture number 5. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 4 before watching this part 5. As we have discussed in the previous lecture, that we will start today the next lecture, that is vector. So let us start as per promise vector analysis today. So, vector analysis, vector algebra. This is a very useful topic for physics because we have a great application of vector in physics. So, what is vector? So, first let me discuss about what is vector. Vector is what? So, vector is that physical quantity, a physical quantity which can be described by magnitude as well as direction, by magnitude as well as direction, called vector quantity. This is the basic definition, right? For example, we have velocity, right? Displacement, weight, force, momentum, acceleration, etc. All these are vector quantity. So, what is vector? Try to understand the basic concept of vector. Suppose someone asks you where is your school, and you want to say that your school is 2 kilometers away from your home. So, will you say that 2 kilometers from your home, a person will reach definitely to the school? No, it is not sure, because 2 kilometer distance from different directions from your house will lead to the different destinations. That will be not unique. So, to specify the position of a school from your house, you need to tell not only the magnitude, that is 2 kilometers, but also you have to tell the direction in which the school is situated. So there is magnitude as well as direction, both are required to describe the position of a school from your house, isn't it? Similarly, someone has to apply some force, and they have to give the direction, that in which direction they have to apply the force. So that if you want to break this pen, say this is a pen and you want to break this, then you have to apply the force and you need a direction. If you apply the force in this direction, you can't break this. So there is one, not only magnitude, but direction is also important to describe force, right? But suppose you have to ask 2 meter milk from a shopkeeper, then will you say that give me 2 kilometer milk from north direction or south direction or east direction? No, there is a meaningless use of direction. There is no need of direction. Just magnitude is enough to specify the volume of milk, that is 2 kilometer. Similarly, if someone asks what is the length of or height of yours, then you will tell that my height is 5 feet 8 inch. Nobody will ask that whether it's at this 5 feet 8 inch in north direction or south direction or east direction or 45 degree with horizon, because these are meaningless words. So some magnitudes can be described by some physical quantity can be described by magnitude only, whereas some physical quantities described by magnitude as well as direction. So those which can be described by magnitude only, they are called scalars, like time, energy, mass, volume, etc., density. These are scalar quantities. And those which can be described by magnitude as well as direction, they are said to be vector quantity. So this is what the definition I have written, that vector quantities are those physical quantities which can be described by magnitude as well as direction. So I hope you got the vector quantity. So one thing is clear, that here is not only magnitude, but direction is also equally important to describe the vector quantity. And therefore, a vector quantity can be described by magnitude as well as direction. And so to give a direction of vector quantity, we have to put arrowhead on vector quantity. For example, if I'll write velocity, then you have to write arrowhead. So a vector quantity can be represented. A vector quantity can be represented with an arrowhead. A vector quantity can be represented with an arrowhead. A vector quantity can be represented. Can be represented with represented with an arrowhead. An arrowhead. Right now, so like this. For example, velocity, what I have represented. Similarly, we can represent force like this, acceleration like this, etc. So these are a vector quantity can be described by an arrowhead, which will represent the direction of this is a vector quantity. It will not exactly represent the direction, but it will represent that these are vector quantity. So vector quantity can be represented like this. Now, representation of vector quantity, and if there are two vector quantities, because I have written the vector algebra. Algebra means what? There is an addition, subtraction, if there is anything possible, or multiplication, isn't it? So all algebraic operations should be applied for vector algebra. So first thing is a scalar multiple of a vector. Suppose this is a vector quantity A is given, and the magnitude is 2 meter, and direction is this. So if you want to write 3a, then there will be another vector which magnitude will be thrice of the magnitude of this. Write it. So there will be another vector quantity which magnitude will be thrice of the magnitude of this, and direction will be same as the given vector. So first thing is that if this is another vector quantity which magnitude is 3a, then magnitude must be equal to 6 meter. And direction will be same. So first thing is a scalar multiple of a vector. We have a scalar multiple of a vector. Right? What is meaning of this? Try to understand. A vector quantity, if k be any scalar, and a be any vector, then A scalar multiple of a vector, that is Ka is a vector quantity, is a vector whose magnitude is thrice of the magnitude of vector A. But direction is same as vector A, right? So this is the scalar multiple of a vector. Now we can add the vector quantity and represent the vectors, type of vectors, say like parallel vectors and unlike parallel vectors. There are two type of vectors called like parallel vectors, right, and unlike parallel vectors. Two parallel vectors are said to be like parallel vectors, right here. Two parallel vectors are said to be like parallel vectors if they have same direction. Vectors if they have same direction. If they have same direction. If they have same direction. Right, irrespective of their magnitude. For example, A and this B, these are the two vectors, this is A and this is vector B, they are like parallel vectors. Vector A and vector B are pair vector A and vector B are, vector A and vector B are said to be like parallel vectors. Like parallel vectors. They have same direction. There is a, their sum is, sum of like parallel vectors is, suppose the magnitude of this is 2 meter, magnitude of this is 3 meter, 3 newton, 2 newton, like that. Then sum of like parallel vectors, sum of like parallel vectors is the sum of, is a vector, vector whose magnitude is sum of magnitudes of two vectors, roots of two even vectors, and direction will be same as given vector, right? So C is a vector that is sum of A plus B, and then there is a vector whose magnitude is equal to 5 meter. This is the C, vector C, right now, which means to reach like this. Now, unlike parallel vectors. So similarly, here two vectors are said to be two parallel vectors. Are said to be unlike parallel vectors if they have opposite direction, right now. So like this, there is a vector, say vector is this one A, and vector A is here, and this is a vector B, another vector is, this is vector A, and now there is a vector that is B, is vector this. So they are parallel, but they are said to be unlike parallel vectors. If the magnitude of this is 3 and magnitude of this is 5, then sum of unlike parallel vectors, here vector A has opposite direction of vector B, in direction but not in magnitude. If they are equal and opposite, then they are called negative vectors. So sum of unlike parallel vectors, sum of or addition of, even write this term vector, it will be addition of two unlike parallel vectors, addition of two unlike parallel vectors, parallel vectors is a vector, vector which sum a, which magnitude is, magnitude is equal to difference of their magnitude, magnitude and direction is, and direction is same as bigger vector, bigger vector. That is vector of greater magnitude, same as direction of greater magnitude, right now. So here C will be a vector as their sum, whose direction will be same as vector A, because A has bigger magnitude, isn't it? and vector c will be here. That will be like this, right? C will be like this, and their magnitude is equal to c is a vector, and magnitude is this is vector c, which is difference is that is c is a vector, this is vector c, and magnitude of c is nothing else but a plus minus of b. This is vector a plus minus of vector b. Magnitude of a plus magnitude of minus of vector b. Even you can write here the difference of their magnitude. So we can write magnitude of vector b. But this is described as c is equal to a plus b. Vector a plus b. Right now, although we are subtracting the magnitude, but this is indeed addition. Because a subtraction has no sense, it is the addition of two vectors. One vector is negative, another vector is positive. They are in opposite directions, so their directions are negative of each other. Now, questions come in mind that if vectors are not either like or unlike, then what will be the sum and how we can calculate the sum of these two vectors. So, for this, there is a triangle law and parallelogram law also. So, there is a triangle law first. Triangle law, let me discuss triangle law. And triangle law is triangle law. Biggest. If A, B, C are three vectors represent three vectors represent sides of a triangle taken in order means head tail arrangement, then vector a plus vector b plus vector c is equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? Try to understand. If I have this vector and say this is a, b and c, right now a, b, c, and taken in order means direction of that will be like head tail arrangement means this is a head and this one is tail for this vector b, c, and for c a, the a is head and c is tail. Head tail system means if I have a vector like say like this vector is represented by magnitude and direction like this, then this one is called head, this one is called head, and this one is called tail. So this is called tail, this area, this one is called tail and this one is called head, right? So head tail arrangement means head of one will lie on tail on other. Head tail arrangement is this, head tail arrangement. That means head of one lies on tail of another. So this is taken in order means either clockwise or anticlockwise, then their sum is equal to 0. This is called head tail arrangement. And a plus b plus c is equal to 0. So we can write simply that a plus b, if this is represented by vector a and this one is vector b, say, and this one is vector c, opposite side of angle of c is c, a b is here, bc is equal to bc vector is equal to vector a, ac is equal to vector b, and ab is equal to vector c. Vector AB is represented by vector C, then A plus B plus C is equal to 0. This is what the triangle law. Or even in better way, if this is c, then another vector is equal to which is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction can be said as minus of c. So we can write here minus of c. This is minus of vector c. Minus of vector c. In that case, if I say that a plus b is equal to minus of c, here we can write this a plus b is equal to minus of c, vector minus of c. It means if two vectors are arranged in vector system, then third vector in opposite direction will give the resultant of these two, right? So we can write, if any two vector triangle law is arranged, that is, if any two vectors is arranged in head tail system, then the third vector which join tail to tail and head to head gives the resultant of first two vectors. What is meaning of this? That first two vectors are arranged in head tail system. Suppose this is a vector A, this one is vector B, then third vector is in this direction, that is tail to tail and head to head. Say, let me write here, draw here some examples. Suppose there is a one vector here, right? And another one is there, this one is also there. Now this is head of one lies on tail of another, right? Now head tail system, head of one is lies on tail of another. Then third vector which will come here in this tail to tail and head to head will give the resultant, right? Now so that will be basically a resultant of these two. This is tail to tail. Say like this. Right. Okay, so that will give the resultant of the two vectors, right? Now this one is A, say this one is B, then that will be A plus this vector is A, this vector is B, and this vector is A plus B, like this. So third one is tail to tail. Here tail to tail is joined and head to head is joined. So that will be the resultant. So here vector A plus vector B is equal to vector C in this one, because C is in opposite direction. I have written tail to tail and head to head. So that is also in this case, that is, if you join them from tail to tail and head to head, then that will be the resultant. Okay, so how to deal with the exact formula and magnitude when they are not at any triangle? In this, there is a parallelogram law, that is called parallelogram law. To find the magnitude of them, that is called, described by parallelogram law. Parallelogram law. What is that? In parallelogram law, if two vectors represent the two adjacent sides of parallelogram, parallelogram then the diagonal of parallelogram then corresponding diagonal of parallelogram then corresponding diagonal of parallelogram gives the resultant of two vectors. Right? Then parallel. What is that and how to deal with the situation? Try to understand. If two vectors represent two adjacent sides of parallelogram, so here is a parallelogram. You know, this is a parallelogram. And here the third one gives the resultant. So say this is vector A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So if this one is represent vector A, this one is B, right? Here if A and B, here if A vector A and vector B represent sides AB and BC of parallelogram, BC of parallelogram ABCD, then corresponding diagonal AC, then corresponding diagonal AC will give the resultant of vector A and vector B. That is vector A plus vector B. How to deal with this magnitude? How to calculate this magnitude? So to calculate the magnitude of this, draw a perpendicular, that is CR, on this extended AB. The direction between vector A and vector B are inclined at angle theta. So this angle must be 180 minus theta, isn't it? So this angle must be 180 minus theta. If the direction between them it's theta, then this angle must be 180 minus theta. So now there is a triangle CRA. In triangle ACR, we can calculate. Drawn CR perpendicular to AB. Right now? Then in triangle ARC, is right angle triangle? If you calculate this, sine theta is perpendicular upon base. So if I'll write here sine theta is equal to, then CR upon what? BC, right? This employee, what will happen, that CR is nothing else, magnitude of CR. BC is what? Magnitude of B. So CR is equal to, we can write CR is equal to B sine theta, magnitude of B sine theta. CR is magnitude of B sine theta. Similarly, BR is equal to, we'll write here, cos theta is equal to this, that will be A cos theta, B cos theta, B cos theta. CR is, similarly, if you calculate B cos theta, because cos theta is also equal to BR upon BC, right now, BR upon BC, and BC is nothing else but magnitude of, what is BC? BC is nothing but magnitude of B. So that is why we can write it. So CR is B sine theta and BR is A cos theta. Now in triangle ARC, AC square is equal to, by Pythagoras theorem, we have AC square is equal to AC square is equal to BR, AR square plus BC, BR square, CR square, AR square plus CR square. AC square is equal to, we can write here, AC square is equal to AR square plus BR square. Get it? So we can write here that AR is nothing else but AB plus BR. AB plus BR whole square plus BR square. AR square plus CR square. This one is CR. Sorry. CR. CR square and CR square. Right? So that will be AC square comes up as AB is magnitude of A plus B cos theta whole square plus B sin theta whole square. So we can write it like A square, if you calculate it, A square plus 2AB cos theta plus B square cos square theta plus B square sin square theta. If I took B square common, then it will be 2AB cos theta plus B square cos square theta plus sin square theta. You know this is 1 cos square theta plus sin square theta. If this resultant is described as in form of R, R is stand for resultant, say this is R. R is resultant of A plus B. Right now? So R is described as A plus B, then R square is equal to, what will happen? Therefore, R square is equal to A square plus 2AB cos theta plus B square. Since cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1, isn't it? So we can write resultant is equal to under root A square plus 2AB cos theta plus B square. And direction of this magnitude is given by, say the direction is phi. If this resultant makes an angle phi, say here, with A, then tan phi is equal to, direction is given by tan phi is equal to B sin theta upon what? If this is phi, try to understand, if this angle is theta, then that angle is also theta because they are corresponding to this. If this is phi, then this is B sin theta perpendicular upon hypotenuse is A plus B cos theta. So this is CR upon AR, that is B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. So magnitude is, angle direction is given by this, right? Direction is given by this and magnitude is given by this. This will give the direction and that will give the magnitude of the vector. So magnitude and directions are given by, therefore magnitude of resultant is R and direction is phi is equal to tan inverse B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. So I hope you got this point, how to calculate the resultant, and this is the formula which you need to learn. So please remember this. This is very, very important, right? Important, and you must remember all these formulas here and this such. So that's awesome, and we will discuss some more about the vectors after the break. Till then, take rest. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you very much.